So your doctor suggested doing a cortisone injection to treat your pain. You are not sure what you should do. Today, I'll answer some of the most common questions that patients have about cortisone shots. Number one, is cortisone a steroid? Two, how do cortisone shots work? Three, are cortisone injections good for arthritis? Four, does it help with tendinitis and bursitis? 5. How long until the effect starts? 6. How long does the pain relief last? 7. Does it help low back pain and sciatica? 8. Does it hurt? 9. Can cortisone increase blood sugars? And 10. Can steroid injections cause weight gain? So, let's talk about cortisone injections today. So is cortisone a steroid? Cortisone is a type of steroid, but they are different from the anabolic steroids used to increase muscles. Cortisone or corticosteroids are type of anti-inflammatory drugs. They are artificially made in laboratory. We have our own natural steroid hormone called cortisol, which is produced in the adrenal glands. There are many types of corticosteroids made in laboratory. Here are some examples. Prednisone, hydrocortisone, dexamethasone, triamcinolone. These corticosteroids can be taken by mouth, in tablets, capsules, or syrups, in inhalers, intranasal sprays, eye drops, topical creams, or injections. Two, how do cortisone shots work? Corticosteroids inhibit the immune system, therefore they reduce inflammation. When we inject corticoids inside a joint, this medication will take a long time to be removed by the body. Because there is no blood supply inside of the joint, the corticosteroid will stay there for weeks or months. And that's what makes the effect of these injections last so long, sometimes up to 6 months. 3. Are cortisone injections good for arthritis? Well, if you are enjoying this video so far, don't forget to press the like button and subscribe to this channel. Yes, corticosteroids reduce inflammation very quickly, and this alleviates the pain and the pressure inside of the joint. However, we can't be giving cortisone shots too often to the same joint. If we do this, the cartilage and the bone will become weaker, and this will actually be more damaging and cause an accelerated process of joint destruction. So we don't do more than 3 injections per year in the same joint. 4. Does it help with tendinitis and bursitis? Yes. When there is an inflammation of a tendon or a bursa, these are outside of the joint, around the joints. Then it might be helpful to reduce that inflammation quickly by doing a steroid injection. Question 5. How long until the effect starts? When we inject corticosteroid inside of the joint, it may take up to 3 days for the patient to notice the pain relief. That is because when we inject inside the joint, which is a closed space, we will be increasing the pressure inside of that joint. That will cause more pain, just because of the pressure. But once the pressure diminishes, the pain improves, and the steroid is also starting to exert its anti-inflammatory effects. 6. How long does the effect last? Well, if the injection is inside of the joint, then it may last between 3 and 6 months. When the injection is around the joint, around a tendon or a bursa, the effect is just a few weeks. But if the problem is resolved, then the pain may not come back. 7. Does it help with low back pain and sciatica? Well, in people who have arthritis of the facet joints of the spine or people who have sciatica due to an acute disc herniation, the injection of corticosteroids in these areas can be very helpful to alleviate the pain. Number 8, does the injection hurt? Yes, it does. The doctor may mix a local anesthetic with the corticosteroid, and this will block the pain for a few hours. 9. Can cortisone increase blood sugars? Yes, and that sometimes is a contraindication. Well, if the patient takes insulin for diabetes, we need to alert the patient that they may need to monitor their blood sugars, especially the day of the injection, because the blood sugars may go up. And then, can steroids injections cause weight gain? Yes, all corticosteroids cause water retention and weight gain. They may also cause the blood pressure to go up, and they can also upset the stomach and cause insomnia and restlessness. Well, so if your doctor offers you a cortisone shot for the treatment of pain, you have more information to decide if you want or not this treatment. And please remember that this video is for educational purposes only. If you have a condition that needs an injection, please talk to your doctor and discuss the pros and cons of a cortisone shot for you. And in case of emergency, go to the nearest emergency department or call an ambulance. Watch my next video here. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.